let us learn about medication order. A physician usually determines the client's medication needs and he orders some drugs or medications to inpatients. The medications orders can be handwritten, typed, pre-printed, verbal, or entered into a computer program and is submitted to the pharmacy by a patient, caregiver, or via fax, computer, or other electronic means. So let us learn the types of medication order. There are mainly four types of medication orders are commonly used in a hospital. A first is a state order. It indicates that the medications is to be given immediately and only once. For example, morphine sulfate 10 mg IV stat. A second type of medication order is single order or one time order. Is for a medications to be given once at a specified time. For example, Econol 100 mg at bedtime before surgery. So, single order means the administration of a drug in a certain time but only one time. The next type of medication order is standing order. The standing order may or may not have a termination date. A standing order may be carried out for a many number of days. For example, multiple vitamins daily. A renewal order must be written and signed by the physician before the nurse can continue to administer the medication. The next is PRN order, means as needed order, or it means administered if needed. This order allows a nurse to judge when a medication should be administered based on the patient needs and even also when it can be safely administered to a patient. Now let us see the essential part of medication order. First one is a client's full name. The client's first, middle and last name should always be used in medication order to avoid the confusion between two clients who have the same last name. The second essential part of medication order is date and the time the order is written. Writing the time of day on an order can eliminate errors when the nursing shift change. Many health agencies use the 24 hours clock, which eliminates the confusion between morning and afternoon times. Next essential part of medication order is name of the drug to be administered. Name of the drug to be administered must be clearly written. In some settings, only generic names are permitted. However, trade names are widely used in hospital and health agencies. Now the next is the dose of the drug. The medication order should also include the amount, the time or frequency of administration, and in many cases, strength too. For example, tetracycline 250 mg 4 times a day. The second example, potassium chloride 10% 5 ml 3 times a day with the meals. Now next essential part of medication order is frequency of administration. The medication order should also include the time or the frequency of administration of the drug. For example, 4 times a day, 3 times a day, 2 times a day. Next essential part of medication order is route of administration. Route of administration must be clearly written in a medication order because it is not unusual for a drug to have several possible routes of administration. Therefore, it is important that the route to be included in the order. Next essential part of medication order is signature of the person who is writing the medication order. The signature of the physician makes the drug order legal request. An unsigned order has no validity. The ordering physician needs to be notified if the order is unsigned. Hope today's information was helpful you all to understand the types of medication order and essential parts of medication order. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe the channel.